Hi, my name is Nick Stasoulis and I work with the main office of the New England Water Science Center. In this video, we will outline the process of setting up a measurement using the SonTek RSSL software. Once you have connected to the ADCP, the system page will be presented. The system page is where all the parameters are entered to configure the M9 or S5 for the measurement. Basically, you work your way down through the menus listed on the system page. The system configuration shows the ADCP serial number, firmware, and software. It also provides the ability to load an existing station template. Under Site Information, select the Change Site Information link and populate the site name, station number, location of the measuring section, field party, boat or float information, measurement number, gauge height, and note the available comments section. All of this information will become part of the discharge measurement summary document. In addition, much of this information can be populated in SV Mobile when imported. Next, select Change System Settings. The transducer depth is determined by measuring from the flat bottom of the transducer to the water line of the tethered boat. Next, set the tagline azimuth by positioning the boat facing upstream, either in the river, on the ice, or on the bank and perpendicular to the cross section. Notice in the diagram shown that the ADCP connector must be facing downstream. Once the boat is positioned, click Start, and allow the instrument time to stabilize, usually requiring 10 to 20 seconds. Then press the stop button before you close the box. The azimuth is essentially a compass bearing from the left bank towards the right bank that is perpendicular to the flow and allows the M9S5 to compute flow angles during the measurement. Other videos in this series discuss the specifics of using this azimuth and other methods for flow angle correction. If you are measuring in a tidal zone, you may need to adjust the salinity setting here. For normal use, the track reference, depth reference, discharge method, and smart pulse HD options will not be changed, but it's important to realize that depth reference can be edited during playback if needed. The lower frequency vertical beam depth may provide better results in high sediment conditions. If needed, you can enter a user input temperature or speed of sound, though this should not be routine. Details on the settings and options in this dialog can be found in the River Surveyor S5M9 manual. The Change Quality Settings link is where you enter your rate of discharge, which will determine the 5% value for each of the measured sections. A user temperature validation reading can also be entered, though it's important to note that the required water temperature check for each measurement must be noted in SV Mobile. The utilities will be discussed in a separate video of this series that covers the pre-measurement tests for RSSL.